Paul Thatcher here with Fight Magazine with Josh Thompson with some really nice hair, Josh. Tell us about that.
You know, just been trying to stay healthy throughout this training camp and get ready for this fight. So everything's been wonderful. Pat stepped up and took the fight. So there was a lot of wishy-washy going on during the fight, during the training camp, wondering who I was going to fight. But now we got that all settled out. We're here, the fight's here, and ready to go. So training camp was good. Injuries are free, and I'm just looking forward to the fight tomorrow night.
And you said up there on the stage that you felt like you weren't ready for the next shot at Gilbert. You felt like you had to work on some things. Tell us about that.
See, I feel like a lot of fighters, what they do is they take rematches right away with the person that they just lost to, and that ends up, they end up with two losses on their record to the same person. Gilbert's done a lot of changes in his game since I've beaten him. I feel like it's almost like probably my time now for me to make some changes to my game. I feel like when I beat him, I was at the top of my game, and it was time for him to make changes. Now that I had that 15-month layoff with injuries, my game kind of took a backslide, and I think it showed in my last fight with him. Granted, we had a great fight. It was a wonderful war, but the thing is in the first fight, I was able to show my technique and everything was better. I outpointed him, and I took the fight to him in all areas. This second fight was more of a brawl, less technical, but it was what the fans, you know, they got the best result out of what they got, what they came for. So I did the best I could, and you know, after taking 15 months off and coming out, and I thought I did a great job of putting on a great performance, but I came up short. And I'm making sure the next time we do fight, the opportunity will definitely, I'll definitely seize the opportunity with a little bit more time.
How is it with you? I mean, you and Gilbert are pretty much friends, right? I mean, you guys are like, it seems like you're brawling like every other week almost. Huh? What, tell us about that.
That's another thing is that I think we want to break from training for the same person. And that's another thing. We spent 2 years, almost 3 years, you know, training for each other. you know, with the layoffs, the injuries, just whatever it was. We spent a lot of time doing that. So it's time now for us to fight other people. You know, there's a lot of other people that we haven't had a chance to train for, fight against. You know, there's Jay-Z, there's KJ Noon. There's George Gergel, there's, you know, we got a lot of top guys in our organization. You know, Pat Healy's one of them. You know, with Justin Wilcox, Brian Travers, all these guys are top guys with like maybe one loss on their record if they have any at all. So these guys they're itching at the bit, really biting at the bit to get to us. And this is the opportunity for them to fight us and you know, for us to fight other guys. So that's what we're looking to do is, like I said, I need to make this changes to my game, and when I do that, I'm going to do it against other opponents, not always worrying that I always have to be at my best to fight Gilbert. Some of these other guys I could possibly get away with, you know, working on one thing or one other thing, you know, and some of them I'll have to be at the top of my game. But I think right now is a good opportunity for me to start getting into a different area, working in different areas of my game and getting them better.
You know, I see that you're still active on the underground, right? You've had some words with Fancy Pants. Would that be one of the guys that you'd like to test yourself against him, or have him test himself against you?
My personal opinion is that he needs to get a couple other fights under his belt before he even gets to the level of fighting someone like Gilbert or myself, or you know, or a Jay-Z. But I mean, he's coming off of a win off of Shaolin. Shaolin's coming off of a 2-year layoff, so I'm not going to give the kid too much credit. Since, to be honest, if you look at the scoring on that, the fight could have went either way. I'll give him credit and say, you know, that he won the fight, you know, and he's coming off of an injury. But the stuff that happened on the forum to me was was something that, you know, you don't turn down a fight with anybody. You know, and then 4 days later, try and call out the champion. I mean, I don't care. I'm not trying to say you need to work your way through me to get to the title. That's the last thing I could really care less about. The biggest thing is that these guys should be fighting. You know, he needs one or two other fights. Fight a Justin Wilcox. You know, fight a Billy Evangelista. Why don't you try fighting a George Gergel, someone who's been active, someone who's fought top guys lately. You know, and who's not that rusty. And then come calling out the champion. Then come fight one of us. Talk Josh to us then. You know, so whatever. But to be honest, he's got a ways to go. You know, he just turned around another fight apparently with Justin Wilcox, you know, for the third time, I believe. So he's trying to be selective on who he fights, trying to get to the top, trying to work his way around other opponents. You know, he's trying to sidestep as much as he possibly can to get to the title as fast as he can. But, you know, I think just it's all money. Money must be tied up in the Northwest for him. So living in the trees.
Well, cool. Thank you very much for your time, and good luck to you tomorrow, Josh.
Hey, guys. Thanks for having me.